Hello friends, good afternoon and welcome back to the series of lectures on Who is Afraid of Virginia Woolf. We were discussing about the characters and we had completed our discussion on the two main characters, George and Martha. As I said, there are only four characters in the play and all these four characters are equally important. So already two are over. The next two I will be discussing now with are, one is Nick and his wife Honey. So this couple represents the younger generation. Nick is, first we will discuss about Nick and then we'll go to the character of Honey. Nick is 30-year-old young man. He is a professor of biology. He is ambitious. He also gets attracted towards Martha. And Nick is a hypocrite. So these are some of his important traits. We will discuss few more traits when we discuss in detail right now. So this Nick represents the younger generation of professors. He is 30-year-old professor of biology. There is a confusion in the mind of Martha. Martha thinks that Nick is a professor of mathematics, but in fact he turns out to be a professor of biology. He is young, he is attractive, and he has athletic body which has given him a kind of sexual appeal. The subject he teaches includes science and technology, which also represents the modern generation. You see the contrast between George and Nick. George on one side represents history, whereas Nick represents biology. And there has been a constant dialogue, a kind of struggle between George and Nick. George claims that history is a better subject and that biology and genetic engineering are horrible and immoral subjects. Further, Nick is a guest, and at certain point of time he forgets that he is the guest and loses his sense of responsibility. He goes into the house of George and Martha. He should have been responsible, because going to someone's house at 2 a.m. in the night time is itself odd. He goes and creates trouble for himself and his wife Honey. Going at such an odd hour creates embarrassment for himself and his own wife. So in the beginning itself, when he arrives with his wife to George's house, we see that he lacks common sense. Nick is shown to be an ambitious young man who has all the credentials to take over the department of biology, and later he also can take over the headship of the institution. And this becomes a reason for jealousy in George, and in fact this is the same reason which attracts Martha towards Nick. He is ambitious, well, and then he is attractive to the old woman of 52 years, Martha. And there are plenty of episodes wherein Nick also shows mutual attraction for Martha, and he takes sides with Martha when Martha is insulting her own husband George. And when it comes to Nick's duties and responsibilities towards his own wife, he seems to be an extremely irresponsible person. In fact, he has married Honey not because of love. He reveals all the secrets of his marriage, thereby showing an irresponsible behavior towards his partner Honey. He is irresponsible because he reveals certain facts which are problematic for the couple. The fact that Nick married Honey because she was found pregnant, and that pregnancy later turned out to be a false alarm. Nick also reveals to George that he married Honey because they were grown up together, and Honey's father had made a lot of property, and with an eye on Honey's property and money, Nick had married this woman. This also shows that he is a hypocrite. Outwardly, he shows that he loves his wife Honey, but he in fact does not love her. It is just a marriage which is baseless. It does not have the foundation of love. At a later stage, Nick seems to be overindulgent, and this is where once again we find him losing the sense of responsible behavior as a guest. He becomes too much involved and indulgent in the affairs of George and Martha, takes the sides of Martha, and he also struggles when George and Martha are fighting against each other. This shows that he is overindulgent and he does not have sense of what to do and what not to do. This is how is the character of Nick. Later, towards the end of act number one, he has already started feeling embarrassed, and he wants to quit from the place, but George insists that they stay together. Later, Nick keeps on asking George about their son to humiliate him further. Nick also humiliates the host and thereby brings trouble on himself, because in the last act, when George announces that we have to play the game, bring up the baby, it hurts Nick because Nick is found impotent. Nick is also disrespected. So he is a man who has lost his self-respect in the course of this story. There are two episodes which show that he has lost his self-respect. One is when he has a rendezvous affair with Martha in the kitchen there, and Martha declares Nick in front of everyone that he is not able to satisfy her despite having a strong physique. This is one incident where he loses his self-respect. He could have avoided getting close to Martha to avoid this further disrespect or dishonor in the house of the hosts. There is another incident where Nick loses his self-respect when the matter of baby is brought up. He loses his self-respect because all his secrets of impotency and all the secrets of his marriage are also out in the open. They are exposed. So that is how he seems to be a victim in the play, in especially in act number 3, when even George and Martha try to call him as houseboy. They ask him to do favors for them. That is how he is made an object of fun towards the end of play. This is how we look at Nick as some sort of a comical character. So these are the traits in the character of Nick. Then let us now discuss about the characters of Honey, who is Nick's wife. Honey is 26-year-old young woman. She is heavily alcoholic. If at all there is excess of alcoholism in the play, in symbolic way, it is represented through the character of Honey. In fact, all the characters, George, Martha, Nick and Honey, all of them drink alcohol, but alcoholism of Honey is shown to be too much. She is not aware that she is in someone else's house and she keeps on ordering for drinks. And that too, she orders them through George, who is the host there. She is over alcoholic. She is not so good looking. This factor becomes important in the play because even in the presence of Honey, his own wife, Nick gets attracted towards a much older woman. So it clearly proves that Honey was not so attractive for anyone. In fact, she is commented with vulgar language by George, who is not even her husband. So her ordinary or plain looks are commented in a vulgar way. And even there is a dialogue when George comments directly in a hurting way about Honey, saying that because she does not have broad hips, she could not have child. So this is a direct attack on the femininity of Honey. So she is not able to keep the marriage in happy way because of her bad looks or her ordinary looks. Then Honey has a painful story. Honey is not a happy woman, although the name sounds very lovely and romantic. But Honey has painful story of her marriage, which she does not want to reveal to others. But in fact, Nick has already revealed about it in front of George, and that makes her behave in a hysterical way. She behaves like a mad person going to the bathroom of the hosts, lying down on the floor of the bathroom, heavily drunk there, vomiting out. So all these awkward situations are created by Honey because of her painful story. And that painful story is because she is childless. She is not able to get a child. Even her husband Nick is impotent. That's the reason why they are childless. And this being childless is a reason of worry for Honey. Among all the other characters, Honey seems to be a little less violent. All the other characters are extremely violent. George is accusing Martha. Martha is trying to dominate over George. Martha is also trying to dominate over Nick. Nick is trying to fight against George. So all these characters are extremely violent. But this character is a little mild. She does not involve herself too much in the matters of others. She is only busy drinking alcohol. She wants to resign herself from the awkward situations. In fact, honey creates the chaos in the first act itself. It is not because she wanted to create a havoc there, but Martha reveals that their son would come for her birthday, for his birthday, and honey asks when the son is coming repeatedly to George and Martha, which hurts both George and Martha emotionally. But on the other occasions, we find that honey is not involved in much of the action that happens in a very violent way in this drama. So this is how is the character of honey. She also identifies herself with her husband. She does not have her independent opinions. She is rather dull, and we can say that she is, out of all the four characters, she is a little sidelined one. And this is about the character of Honey and Nick, the younger couple. Now, the irony of this play is that the young couple goes to the house of the hosts. The time is odd, of course. When they go there, they expect that the elder couple has some sensible behavior. They expect to take some guidance from the old couple about marriage life. But it turns out to be the exactly opposite of it. In the beginning, when they go to the house of George and Martha, Nick and Honey are sensible. They behave properly, in the beginning at least. But George and Martha, being the older couple, should have been a role model for the younger couple, but they start behaving like crazy couple, accusing each other, humiliating each other. They set a bad example in front of the younger couple, Nick and Honey. So this is the irony of the play. We will discuss about few more characters of the play, not in the play. Of course, these are the only four characters that we see in the play, but we will discuss about the other elements, ideas and key concepts and themes in the play in the next lecture. Thank you.